All right, I call this meeting to order at 2 p.m. This is Board President Ethan Bertram. I'm present, and also here is
George Thurlow,
Director of the Board, for all of our loyal listeners. So this meeting is called to order. This is the internship committee meeting, a special meeting, the first meeting of the committee. At this time, we are going to enter the public comment period. Members of the public may speak on any matter under within the subject jurisdiction of the internship committee. And I'll say I've identified a mistake in this agenda. It says of the formation committee, but we are the internship committee here today. So if anyone has any public comment on any matters not on the agenda, now's the time.
Thank you.
Seeing none, well, we're so glad to have you. We'll move to item one, welcome and introductions. Internship committee, both of us have previously to George's appointment to the board, we've discussed the internship program.
Mm-hmm.
So it was appropriate that both of us continue to serve and work together on this. Anything you have to add to the board?
No, just no. Thank you. Thank you for allowing me to serve on this committee.
Oh.
I think it'll be really good. And I also think that this committee is not going to last long.
Right.
I think we're going to do a couple of things, and mostly it was formed, I believe, to get moving on this because we had to move really fast. But then I don't see, then there probably won't be a need for this committee as we go forward.
Right. And I, at the end of the meeting, I mean, I have an agenda item that perhaps will put us in a new capacity going forward that allows us
okay.
to more efficiently work.
Okay.
Because
great.
Right now, I see, and this I think this is consistent with our welcome, because
mm-hmm.
I see that we have two tasks of this committee, well, many, but two large areas. One, to develop the program, next, to administer the program.
Mm-hmm.
I think perhaps in the future we may want to separate those two so that we have a working group to establish the program that can meet in an efficient manner, and in the future, a group and a formal committee
to manage.
Maintain and manage.
Yeah. I agree.
Any public comment on welcome and introduction before we move on to item two? Well, thank you all for being here. Great to see everyone. Now, item two, elected chair of the internship committee. Set the roles and responsibilities of the chairperson of the internship committee and elect a committee member to fill the position.
I would suggest that since we're short one member, and that was the member that I was going to nominate to be chair, that we table this to our next committee meeting.
I think that's great. One thing that we can do if we want is we could set the roles and responsibilities now, or we could also table that with it. Do we want to push that all?
Well, let's table that for now until we get to what you want to discuss about the future
great.
Of the committee. And that may end up defining the roles and responsibilities.
Fantastic. Okay, so tabling item two. Now moving to item three, overview, goal setting, and mission statement. Oh wait, before we table it, actually, did anyone have any public comment on the election of a chair? None? Cool. All right, item three, overview, goal setting, and mission statement. Create a brief list of goals and a one-sentence mission statement. Any suggestions?
Did I get that other mission statement?
He can't answer
no.
that question.
He can't.
No, because he's a
he's
board
a
member.
Board member.
And
yeah.
attending our committee.
So I think you just laid out the goals. I think the goals are to establish a program and to determine a structure for administration of the program, and then finally monitor the program and establish metrics for success. To me, those are the three goals that we should have.
So to establish an internship program, to determine a structure to administer the program.
Right.
And then
create metrics for success in order to evaluate the success of the program.
Cool. And And perhaps one thing we can add to that is work with the appropriate stakeholders, just since this will be a partnership. Maybe that'll
that's
be
a good
the
idea.
Second point. So after, to establish an internship program, work with, work and coordinate with all
different partners. Because as it's becoming clear, as this internship program gets promulgated, and what I'm beginning to hear is that there may be other independent internship programs that are going to start popping up that are actually not at all, have nothing to do with this particular one. So we should think in terms of what this committee is going to handle, requests from nonprofits that want to set up their own internship programs, and City College, which
right.
may want to set up its own. So I think your idea of however you want to put stakeholders or partners or, but this committee will work with those different partners.
Yeah, excellent. So just right now what we have, to establish an internship program that will work with partnering stakeholders to determine a structure to administer the program and create metrics in order to evaluate success of the program. That sounds good. And what we are leaving out of there is, so we have determined a structure, but we don't actually say that this committee will be involved in administering the program. At this time, do we want to?
No, I don't think we want to do that.
Great. Okay. Any public comment on the mission statement? I'd like to turn what I just read into a motion.
Okay.
For our mission statement.
Okay, I'll take it as a motion and second it.
Fantastic. And we'll do a roll call vote since we don't have someone here. We have to do that. And just for the record, Director Jordan isn't here, unless in case that wasn't clear.
Okay.
But so I'm Director Bertrand, and aye.
Aye.
Director Thurlow is aye as well. Motion passes 2-0. One member of the committee absent. So moving right along to number 4, consider recommendations regarding the creation of an internship program. The internship committee will discuss ideas for the creation of an IBCSD internship program and consider making a recommendation to the board of directors. If this ties right into number 5, like, we can also
I don't know which is the cart and which is the horse.
How about we actually take it out of order and go to 5 first to hear what you've been working on.
Okay.
So we're going to go to item 5 at this time, presentation from Director Thurlow on his efforts to develop a UCSB internship program that could work in conjunction with the IBCSD. And we also have a draft memorandum of understanding, which you can find in the back.
So, I'm not going to go through this line by line. It was presented to the board at the last meeting, so really what I'd rather do is respond to specific questions. I would just say this is that the purpose of this program is, first and foremost, I think, to give university students an opportunity to get engaged and involved in their community and to do that in an academic way, which not only provides them with academic growth, but also allows them to learn how to engage a community like Isla Vista. Second of all, it furthers the spirit of the trustees report, the UC Santa Barbara Foundation trustees report, which stated that the university should take a broader academic role in Isla Vista, not just a financial or a funding role, but a academic role where we get more involved in academic and providing academic experiences in Isla Vista. Third, and just almost as important, is it provides, without a tax structure for the CSD, it allows us to have staff that can carry out the mission of the CSD in the time between now and when a more stable funding source is established. And finally, I think it, from a practical and political point of view, it's going to be an easier sell to the university when it comes to ask or to enter into negotiations about the expenditure of its $200,000 commitment if some of that money is aimed at paying students for academic work. Now, a couple of questions that arose, the questions that have arisen, let me try and answer those. That are, first and foremost, why just poli-sci? Well, poli-sci is launching a community internship program. They're trying to revitalize it. So the timing was really perfect to go to poli-sci and say, how about this as part of your getting this program going? There's not an intention to just have poli-sci students. And I've been approached by people in sociology and history as well as the Interdisciplinary and Humanities Center about getting their students involved. So that, and then just in the last week or so, we've talked about getting art students involved in their own internship program out here in Ivy under the auspices of a nonprofit. So this program is meant this first quarter. The other piece of it was poli-sci was able to move quickly, and we're going to be able, if the board approves this, we're going to be able to start this program at the beginning of spring quarter. And so we can immediately start, and poli-sci was able to say we can do that. So that's the other reason for poli-sci. I see that a year from now, this is a program that's much bigger and much broader and includes all kinds of majors. The other issue is they need to be paid. The poli-sci people did not want to deal with all of the paperwork involved in hiring students, and then there's a whole bunch of paperwork when a student separates from the university, a lot of paperwork. And they just didn't want to do that. And particularly as we look forward to, the idea would be is we'd have 2 to 5 interns this spring, double that in the summer, and then triple that in the fall. Okay. This is a beta. This is a test. We all agree that there's going to be problems that occur here. There's going to be misunderstandings. There's going to be questions. There's going to be mistakes. But the idea is to use this as a test so that then we can ramp it up. So that's kind of where it's at. Oh, and the last part is where's the money going to come from? So I've solicited a $1,500 donation. It'll be transparent at the point at which we actually agree and it goes forward. I'll be happy to give the name to the board. The person is already funding political science fellowships, and that's part of their philanthropy. And so the first 15, and the other thing was that $1,500 was written out immediately. So I was able to get the money right now. So we have the first $1,500 in the Alumni Association bank account under separate. Associated Students has voted, my understanding, to give us $3,000, but I have no details for that for this first quarter. So if there's anybody in the public that has any more information about that, would love to hear. But otherwise, I'm going to follow up with AshCon next Tuesday before the board meeting to finalize that.
And do you know if that's coming from the Senate? Did they vote on that, or is that his office?
I believe the Senate voted on
cool.
it. Yeah.
Fantastic.
Now, and the idea is that it would be great if they could, if they were to fund it this summer.
Yeah. So at that time, all the funding for the summer program would be coming from them and...
I think that, see, that's what we want to be able to do is to have this program be a huge success in the fall and then be able to not only go to AS, but go to the university and go to private donors and say, hey everybody. And a matching thing is usually the easiest. Okay, donor, you put up 5, the university will match it, AS will match it. But essentially what we figure is about at $12, if you do the math, $12 an hour, 10 hours a week is 120 times 10 weeks is $1,200. that's about, so we need about $1,200 per intern, and that's for 10 hours a week. The other piece of it that we all should know is PoliSci is willing to give credit and actually wants to give academic credit, but those, that credit has, and those hours that are for the academic credit have to be kept separate from the dollar paid. So each intern's really going to have two time cards. One is for the academic side, where they're going to get credit for this, and the other's going to be where they get paid. You cannot pay for academic units work.
But they can still be, they can be doing both concurrently?
Or? Well, they should try not to do both concurrently.
So they should ask for either, or a deal should be made where they're either doing the internship for academic credit, or they're doing it for...
Well, and again, the Office of Undergraduate Students has said it's fine for them to do both at the same time. Just keep the hours separate. So, and even if they're working on the same project, just keep the hours separate.
Meaning in the recording sense,
or
yeah,
in
I'm
the recording,
work?
In
oh,
the recording
okay.
sense.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. So then, with the $1,200, if it costs roughly $1,200 for to bring on an intern at $10 an hour for 10 weeks,
$12 an hour, none of that minimum wage stuff.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Just kidding.
I'm all for it.
10 hours a week, which isn't very much.
Right. So, are we looking to get and something in addition to the 1,500 private contribution? Like, are we looking to approach the university for this spring quarter?
No. What I was thinking was, we'd have 4,500, and so we'd have enough for maybe four interns.
Oh, so 4,500 in private contribution?
No, 3,000 from the AS.
Right. Perfect.
That's what I'm thinking, that the AS, but we have to make sure that's their commitment. If it's not, then we kind of have to go back to square one and come up with another probably $1,500. And the 1,200 for 10 hours, figure people may go over that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I think, the first thought that I had when we spoke about having the two interns to start off, I thought that was a great idea because that gives us an opportunity to take on something that we can hopefully carry out. The initial thought of bringing on the whole program in the spring, that
I agree.
That was hard to...
And PoliSci doesn't want to do it either.
Yeah.
They feel like, they want to just have two. And I'm trying to push them a little bit to see if we can have three or maybe four. I don't think we should have more than four. And if you have three, one thing is, could you assign them to a committee, for example, as one of their things? So one of the things they could be doing is sitting here right now taking the minutes. I know the other committee I'm on, there's a whole bunch of things that an intern could be working on, so.
Totally. And can I ask a few questions on the
menu? Oh, yeah.
So one part, in point three, we have selection of interns and provision of academic credit associated. Oh, wait, sorry. I'm looking at the wrong part of that. The second sentence, selected by the Department of Political Science after consultation with the IBCSC. Any details on what that might look like?
I just threw that in there. I think we all want... Certainly the Isla Vista Special Office of Special Assistant does not want to be involved in the selection. And I don't think the CSD wants to be involved in the selection either. I can already tell you that I've received in my CSD account a number of people who really want to have this internship, and I don't want to be involved in saying no. I'd rather have PoliSci, you know. And I think that's what the CSD should be careful about, is that it looks too much like I'm calling PoliSci and telling them, you got to take this person because they worked on my campaign.
So with that in mind, would you like to take out the consultation part?
I put it in there only because it seems, like something that should be done. It would just be fair.
Yeah. So maybe what that could look like is if their committee met with our committee to discuss what they're looking for in candidates.
Yeah, I was thinking of it much more in a broad sense of, because they're thinking in terms of, they actually already have some specific ideas about what they're looking for. So, for example, they want to really focus on their honors program students. Well, I mean, the CSD may have a feeling like, well, maybe that's not the best route to go or what. But it may be easier. I think you may have a good point here is that at least, I mean, the other thing about this is that this MOU lasts until we amend it. And I can just say we probably don't want to amend it a whole lot. Just because of the bureaucracy.
Totally.
So I'm happy to take it out. It was put in there as in the spirit of cooperation.
Yeah, well, I think if it was something more on the broader sense of us just having a conversation about what they're looking for or some other aspect of the process,
okay.
I think that would be good. I was just wondering what ideas you had on that. I definitely like the actual project work will be assigned by the CSD with oversight between the Office of Special Assistant for IV for payroll compliance and CSD for work compliance. Do you think that at this point we have to hammer out what that might look like?
No,
or?
I wouldn't get into those. I mean, essentially what I'm saying there is students have to do Kronos. Are you familiar with it? Is anybody here? Okay. Students have to do Kronos. It's an automated time card system. It's a pain. It's a pain for students. It's a pain for administrators. It's a pain for HR. It's a pain for everybody. So we're only in there to make sure that they fill out their Kronos time card, because if they don't get paid.
Right.
And so that's why we're in there. And then we're going to be, and then I think loosely we're going to be checking in. Susan in my office, is going to check in with CSD to say, hey, this person worked 40 hours last week according to their time card. Is that, who was supervising that work? And you know, so that's the only thing that we're gonna do.
Cool. Should there be any mention in here about where the interns might work? Any mention that?
I don't think we know.
Because I know it's preliminary right now. But do you think we wait until we figure that
when
out?
When we wait, I think the board should think about how they want to do that. It was discussed briefly in the formation committee. So I think by the time the interns start, there may be some, we may have better ideas about where they're going to work.
Okay. Cool.
And also what equipment they're going to have.
And is there any public comment on anything we discussed right now? Any questions for George or myself, or questions on the document? Sam?
I mean, one thing that's kind of striking me here is it seems like with this level of reward structure, it's kind of on its way to becoming the end-all be-all of the internship program for the CSD, and that kind of strikes me as contradictory to the essence of what the CSD is, because it would rapidly become a UCSB-dominated internship program if we're offering them this much. So it just concerns me that it wouldn't reflect the population of IV in its ability to provide internships to CC students or even unaffiliated members of the community.
I think that's an excellent point. That's an excellent. First of all, I would say that having a student internship program, UCSB, I'm not going to be able to control the interns. I've never been able to control students. If anything, that we could be UCSB could be creating this organization, which at some point is not totally in the interest of UCSB. So I think we're going to empower a number of interns. My vision is these are the future leaders. My vision is these are the future Ethans, who eventually end up running for the board. I think your point about community involvement is a great one. We had a discussion in another committee about the idea that we have to be careful, I think, as a government agency. I'm gonna say this, and it may just be my own background in the private sector, but having people work for nothing is very problematic in the state of California. you gotta pay people if they're gonna do work that you normally would pay for. So if you can have people answer telephones, for the most part, you gotta pay them. And so that's why there's the pay piece of this, which is, plus, I think we should pay students. Now, City College is, I think, a whole other thing. I think once this thing gets going, that by summer, City College will jump in. Obviously, I'm gonna talk to Jeff Green, who's their, the head of their foundation, and I think he'll be all over this. He's a longtime supporter of Isla Vista issues, and he's gonna have his own intern program. And then that's gonna be a different MOU. It's gonna look totally different. So I see City College quickly jumping in on this. The issue is more community, how do we create internships for students? And I think that's kind of for the other members of the community. I think that we go then, when this thing gets going and we get organized and we have it managed right, and it's not like this totally a mess, and that's what I'm worried about. Then we go to people like Leonore at the teen center and say, let's set up a paid internship for your teens. And I think she'd be all over that. So I think your point is really, really good. And I think that as we go forward, we better not leave anybody out of this. But as I said, there's already this percolating where a nonprofit that Kim Yasuda is working with is very interested in having their own internship program totally involved in arts in the community. And it'd be separate from this. And here's the thing is, it doesn't, if the CSD board rejects this, it's very possible that Poli-Sci and my office will go ahead and do the internship program. We just won't do it in concert with CSD. And instead, and that's where you should worry about the university, because then I'm gonna tell the interns what to do. This is where my sense is the board chair and the officers and the board itself are gonna direct the interns and tell them what to do. Is that sort of answer your concerns, or do you think?
Can I allowed to respond?
Sure,
yeah.
Sure.
Okay. I just wanted to make, I was definitely not in any way against paying the interns. I think that's
okay.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
I think it's great that we have the funding to do that. My concern was just making it clearly delineated that it is an inroad into the CSD's internship program, and that it does not become the CSD's internship program, to allow other venues into that same pool of interns working under the board.
So in a perfect world, what would your vision be in terms of an internship program?
I mean, in a perfect world, if, as you said, if SBCC could back and if other community organizations could back and provide the same sorts of benefits, then you could take interns from all of those areas and then have the CSD itself manage them and manage
yeah.
the hiring process.
Yeah. The hiring process, so you're a little concerned about the hiring process, the
yeah.
selection process. Well, here's what I would suggest we do is we go ahead and try this. I mean, we're only talking about two interns, one quarter, 10 weeks gone, over, before we blink of an eye. But let's look at how it turns out, because I think Poli-Sci is gonna wanna get their very best and brightest and most committed students into this program. And then once they're here, they're totally under the management of the CSD. I really have no idea, right now sitting here, I have no idea what they would do.
I have a bunch of ideas that I'll
okay.
throw out when we get to item four.
Okay, but I will tell you this, I will commit this and we can add this to whatever motion we have, or we can make it as a separate motion, and that would be is that I will commit to approaching City College in the next 2 weeks and seeing if they can't jump in on this. Except they're on semester. So it would have to be a summer. I don't know. What do you think? Jonathan's here from the Community College Board of Trustees, ready to jump in. I mean, does this sound reasonable?
I think this is something we'd be happy to do, 100%. I think having it start spring quarter with UCSB is better for us, because we wouldn't be able to.
How about in the summer?
Summer would work.
Okay.
We have two summer sessions, and then our fall starts in August, so.
Okay. Do you think Jeff's the right vehicle?
Yeah, I would say bring in Jeff and then President Beebe.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Well, I think Jeff will bring in the president.
Right, he'll bring him in.
Yeah. Okay. I think it's great. That'll get us going so that by summer we can have some community college students involved.
Yeah, and obviously I was a City College student, and that was always my constant thing because I was so involved with the self-governance initiative and different community projects, and it was always a question of, well, I found my way to get involved, but how do I get my classmates involved? Because it wasn't easy to get involved. I just kept pushing it. So that's something that we need to keep considering going
right.
forward. And I think this provides us with an excellent opportunity to get started. And
yeah.
it's up to us to keep looking for more opportunities to
right.
continue it.
So the other thing I should point out, because something you said just sort of prompted me, that it's kind of glossed over in here. But it's very clear that under university policy, now this will be different if we have nonprofits, but under university policy, student interns cannot be paid to do political work. And so we have to be really clear at the outset is that these students cannot work on the tax campaign if they're UCSB paid. And so as we move towards that, we just want to make sure that we don't accidentally have them working on that.
Totally, and I think going forward in all aspects of our district, we're going to need to have a conversation about separating what's government work and what's political.
Right.
But now I see, Batsheva, you've joined us. Do you have anything you can tell us about the $3,000 that was allocated by Senate?
I was literally just texting Ashkan about that. So. It's definitely in the minutes. It was passed during the meeting that went till 1, and I left early to write a paper, and I wasn't feeling well, so I wasn't at the vote. But I believe it did pass. But to clarify, I'm gonna try to go back into
okay.
the minutes and just to like make sure. But
was it for spring quarter?
I believe so. Yes. It was
$3,000
for spring quarter.
Okay. So I still have to work. I'll be happy to work on the details of how that money gets transferred over, because we're going to have to get that money moved over before spring quarter starts.
Mm-hmm. I'll find out for sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you know the date of the meeting by any chance, or the week it would have been? So I could pull it up here.
It was either...
It would have been last week, right?
I think it was 2 weeks ago.
Two.
Yeah, it was the last... It was either the second to last or the last Senate meeting. I don't remember which one.
Oh, okay. Perhaps the 8th?
Yeah, maybe. Maybe the 8th.
And while I'm looking at this, Jonathan, I know you had your hand up before. Did you say everything?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Cool. Is there any other questions? No. Okay, so I'll try to find that later on. But I mean, those were my primary questions with the document. I definitely agree that we should move quickly with this.
Okay. So I can't make a motion or second it or vote on this. So
then we can't recommend it at this meeting because.
But it is agendized for the board meeting. Since since it was introduced to the board at the last meeting, and it was circulated to the board,
yeah.
It's just the board doesn't necessarily have to have it come out of a committee
correct.
To consider it.
Right.
So I think that we should just say, "Are you as president should put it on the agenda?"
Yes, and we agreed at that at the board meeting.
Right.
So okay. So then I guess that wraps up our
okay.
discussion on this item.
Okay.
Now, number four, we're going back to this item, consider recommendations regarding the creation of an internship program. We can discuss ideas for what the program might look like. And we don't have to go too in detail here, but
mm-hmm.
just I know one of the things that
many of us board members are finding right now is that it takes an incredible amount of time to prepare for facilitating these meetings. The biggest part, setting up the agenda, providing the notice in compliance with the Brown Act, setting up the room, taking the minutes, compiling that all in a succinct way and releasing it. That's something that we're still figuring out, and we're developing a method to all the madness, but definitely I see us having interns being able to help with that as a great, something that could really help the operation of the district. In addition to setting up the meetings, I think something that could be really exciting is having interns participate in the meetings by helping deliver staff reports and introducing items on the agenda. I know at this last meeting, I did a lot of talking on introducing things because I placed the agenda items on, but that also took away from my ability to make decisions because I was so, well, it complicated my ability, it didn't take away, but because I was focused on making this presentation and then also making decisions. So I think that could be a great benefit too, and that could be really exciting for the interns and provide them with a great opportunity to participate, not making the decision, but in informing the board on the information they need to make the decision. Those are some ideas that I have.
So another one I would throw out is that to assist, again, going back to this idea, to assist Father John's efforts in terms of organizing community volunteers and community volunteer events.
Totally, and with that, I guess we would want, hopefully, an intern to be assigned to each committee to carry out the efforts of that committee, including this one someday, perhaps. any comment from the public on what you think might be great components of an internship program serving the district?
Well, I'm not sure if this is something you've already discussed, but maybe some kind of like educational part, or I mean, like
that's a great idea.
Teaching them, like,
public outreach.
Yeah,
right?
Like what the CSD is,
right,
what it does, like what a special district means, and just kind of informing them on like
that's
maybe,
a great idea.
Yeah, its creation or yeah.
And is that an educational component as part of the training of the interns, or larger public outreach?
Both. I mean, if you're an intern for the CSD, you should know, A, what it is in kind of a broader sense, but also like what it means for IB, too.
Yeah, I mean, just going out there, and even if it was just start with, go out to the business community and tell them about this group, and that they create a flyer that they can put out there. And then even go out to the media, and you know.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's a great idea. I think one intern could do nothing all quarter long, but just do public outreach where they're going out and saying, "Here's when the meetings are.
Yeah.
Here's where they meet. Come in. They want public input."
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely.
It's a good idea.
Any other public comment ideas? Jonathan?
Your interns could do a lot of research.
Absolutely.
That I'm sure is something that is a burden on you guys to look up everything and get it prepared. So even researching attorneys, something like that.
An easy
project. Spend a week, give us a list of everything.
Yeah, I think ultimately, who the interns are reporting to in this initial outside of it will be pretty limited. It'll probably be to a board chair or to the board secretary, to an officer.
Mm-hmm.
But in the future, when we have a larger class of interns,
Board member gets an intern?
I don't know either. Well, that's a possibility. That could be complicated, too. But an intern reporting to the committee chairperson to help with whatever
everything
they need to facilitate
everything.
Committee. So I think
making nice
could,
little binders like this.
Yeah, and doing things a little more complex too.
A little
just
more academic than this.
But yeah, and these are all things that we can continue
to
discuss when this comes before the board.
I think the board's going to have lots of ideas about tasks for the interns. I don't think there'll be any shortage of work.
Yeah. Absolutely. So I don't think we have to take any action on this item either.
I was wondering, so I think this is going off the point of the UCSB internship becoming the CSD internship, like not blurring the lines too much. Would you guys be voting to create a CSD internship program and then it's populated by the people hired at UCSB? Or you create an internship program, you can't pay anyone yourselves, but you accept the interns from UCSB, so you create that.
I think that's a good point, is that and so maybe that's at our next meeting. What we do is we put on the agenda what a broader intern program looks like. So in other words, we get going on this one, and this one was all about time is of the essence, because PolySci wants to broadcast widely, but I told them, well, wait for the CSD, because we don't want to make it look like. So actually their publicity out there right now just says Isla Vista internship. But I think it would be a great idea at the next meeting to talk about what would a broader internship program be and who would populate it. And maybe by that time we have comments from City College as well as Kim's nonprofit group and maybe others.
I think the Teen Center is a great idea.
Teen Center.
Cool. Sam?
Yeah, to kind of build off that, I see moving forward with the internship program with the funding a bit of an issue. Because if we create the internship program within the CSD and we're paying interns directly, we would have issues of various different wage caps between interns from different sources depending on who's funding us for what. As opposed to if UCSB is giving a financial incentive for people to go participate, it's not the CSD itself creating that discrepancy, it's limited to the sources.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and I think we just put, I would argue that the $12 is kind of a bottom. That if agencies can't pay $12 an hour, they should really rethink. Because if you believe in livable wage and all those sorts of things, but I do think that, and I have a feeling that there'll be other members of the board that'll be incredibly sensitive to the idea that this is somehow UCSB trying to run the CSB. And I just see it almost as the opposite, which is just like UCSB does not run Associated Students. I don't think UCSB is going to run this intern program. We're just figuring out a way for them to get paid and to get some kind of academic experience out of it. But you're going
to
be here to keep an eye on this.
Of course.
Promise.
Anything else in this item? No? Okay. So we've now made it through the agenda, and we're at item 6, future meeting dates and agenda items. Unless there's anything else you wanted to discuss within those.
No.
Fantastic. So one agenda item that I would like to have on the agenda is consider recommending to the board of directors that this committee be an ad hoc committee.
Okay.
Going forward, I think it's a recommendation that we could consider, and with that we can discuss the various ways that could allow us to do that in the meantime and then have it move to something else. But
so feel free to not answer this if you can't, but should we anticipate that there'll be a structure by our next committee meeting to add members to this committee?
I think it's something we should keep in mind. I don't know about anticipate, but
okay.
That's a good question.
Because I think this is one of those committees that the quicker we can bring in other partners, Associated Students, PolySci, City College, and have them all at the table.
Absolutely. So let's add that to the agenda as well. committee participation from partners.
Right. I just wasn't sure if there was, if we were in the, if we, and again, I'll keep it narrowly focused to this committee's work, but will this committee have a process for soliciting new members by the next board meeting?
We need to get direction from the board of directors first on what that process is.
Okay.
Which, so we may.
Okay.
But that'll depend on the ruling of the board. But I think, well.
Oh, and the next committee should have an election of a chair.
Yes.
If she doesn't come next time, for sure she's the chair.
If you're not at the
if you're not, that's a standard rule. I mean, I think it's almost part of Robert's Rules of Order. So you don't show up for a meeting, you get assigned the chair.
Okay, so we have election of chair. Update of the MOU, because at that time the board's going to have decided some things.
Okay.
So. And then just a general continue discussing details of the program.
Right. And do you want to meet, I don't know, Friday afternoon, really?
Like, do it again at this time?
I'd rather not meet Friday afternoon.
Oh, I'm fine doing another time.
You want to, I guess we don't dare have it after the policy committee.
No, that wouldn't recommend
that. Yeah.
I would say Tuesday, probably, because the other meetings I've noticed went pretty long, and I can imagine them continuing going. It's hard to estimate.
Yeah, well, the formation committee went an hour and a half.
Yeah.
So, and
well,
I can't see this committee going very long.
No. So you can put this one first.
For like 7:30 in the morning?
7 a.m.?
I'm fine with that, but we do need a third member here.
Yeah. Well, why don't we go ahead and set a committee after you consult with her on a time.
If it's okay with you, I'll take the lead on.
Yeah. Tuesday mornings are not good normally for me. But Tuesday afternoons, sure.
Okay. Cool.
I don't think it should be the same day as a board meeting, though.
No, I don't either. And I don't think we'll need
it also means that we don't have to rush to get the minutes out.
Totally. But I think as far as we proceed from here, the next meeting can be scheduled using the same direction as this first meeting was from the board of directors, so I don't think we have to take any action.
Okay.
Other than we will look at how to do the agenda. But no, still, I don't think we need a motion. And, I mean, we've gone through the whole agenda. Is there any other questions from the public?
I was just going to say that I went through the minutes for both Senate meetings, and it doesn't look like there was any action taken on the money. It was only mentioned in Ashburn's report. So unless the minutes mess something up, which I highly doubt, I don't think that they voted on anything. So that would be something that you would want to be on the agenda for this week's Supreme Court, probably.
Okay.
Okay. I'm meeting with Ashcon next Tuesday.
I was going to call him right after this just to make sure. Also, in his report, he said that there were going to be 3 interns, and it was going to be like $15,000 or something. Maybe $1,500.
$1,500, yeah.
Yeah. So maybe.
And we've gone kind of back and forth about whether we should do stipends or hourly, and I think we should do hourly. I think stipends get a little loosey.
Yeah.
But if we don't have the 3,000, then it's going to be tight.
I mean, there's no reason why you wouldn't get the money if you requested it for
spring quarter,
like the first week.
Right.
Definitely at the Senate meeting. But yeah.
Okay.
Any other public comment? All right.
Is the political science department, they're sending out the email about the application to all poli sci students, like next week or soon?
I thought they had sent out. Are you a poli sci student?
Yeah.
I thought they had sent something out, but
they did send something out. It was forwarded to me.
Okay.
But it was just like a one line that stay tuned for.
Okay. So the person you should contact, and I would email her directly, is Allison Kelleher, K-E-L-E-A-G-R. She's an adjunct professor in poli-sci, and she's handling the applications.
Okay. Thank you.
You gonna go for it?
No, I just like, because I feel like a lot of people don't know about it right now, so like telling like my classmates, like, oh, if you're interested in an internship, you should like apply.
That's great.
Get the word out.
Thank you. Any other comment before we consider adjourn? No?
Move to adjourn.
Second.
Great. Jesus.
Let's
that's
see.
Great.
I.
15 minutes.
I.
I.
Natalie Jordan absent, 2-0. Meeting is adjourned at 2:50 p.m.